Welcome to our 28th annual Christmas concert. We are dedicating this concert tonight to Bruce Corwin and to Ray Brown, two directors that we lost this year. And they will be sorely, sorely missed. For tonight's performance, I'd like to present Sue LeMay, our new director, who took over in the middle of the summer, and this is her first official concert. Sue?
Thank you. joining us this evening. It's a real pleasure to be here and to have such a wonderful crowd. I think we've got a full house, almost standing room only in the back. That was selections from the Nutcracker Suite by Tchaikovsky. Specifically, there was March, Dance of the Sugar Plum Fairies, Arabian Dance, Waltz of the Flowers, and then finally, the Russian Dance. The next piece we'd like to do is a Cambridge Carol. This is based on a 16th century French secular song, and then in the 20th century, words were added. We know it as Ding Dong Merrily on High. We would now like to present two of our band members, Marilyn and Mark. and whose last name I can never get right, so we're going to make sure it's right this time.
Longile.
It looks a lot harder on paper. This song was originally written by Frank Lesser back in 1944. He and his wife lived in New York City. They were going to have a dinner party, and they wanted something to kind of ease people at the door. You know how if you've ever had guests. And so it was such a hit that they became very popular on the cocktail circuit in New York City. Everybody wanted them in their guest list. And this went on, it was sort of their ticket to fame, until 1949 when Frank sold this song to MGM. His wife was not very happy, and it became part of the film Neptune's Daughter. We all remember Neptune's Daughter, right? Not so much. But it was the Academy Award-winning Best Original Song in 1949. There are two renditions of it in the movie. The first is by Ricardo Montalban and Esther Williams, and the second time is by Red Skelton and Betty Garrett. This is kind of like call and response here, that we have someone who's trying to leave and someone who's trying to convince them maybe they should stay a little bit longer. Those of you who sometimes attend our summer programs may have heard us play Instant Concert, which is a medley of some 31 different snippets all woven together into a piece. We have the Christmas version of Instant Concert for your pleasure now. It out. There are probably only 20 some odd Christmas tunes in the literature, and a lot of what we're doing tonight is some kind of a medley of some or all of those, or at least an attempt. What we would like to do now is one that is seasonal rather than a Christmas carol. It's called Snow Day Celebration, and it starts off with, well, you know how it is. You've seen the weather report. You're expecting some snow. Check out Friday if you haven't looked at Friday yet. Okay. I'm showing 6 inches.
Oh, no.
Okay. Yeah. And that doesn't even count Saturday. But you know, it's like you're ready for it. You got firewood in. You went grocery shopping. You bought your milk and your eggs and your bread. Fought the lines at Shaw's, Hannaford, wherever. Price Chopper. And then this guy gets that look, and here comes the first kind of flake. And he said, here we go. Usually that's for a 3-footer snowfall. 6 inches is like, you know, I know it's not Maine, but it is kind of just a dusting. Snow day celebration.
I'm a skier. Our next piece is called Christmas Pipes. It's a relatively new piece written in 2007. Okay. By a composer who was born in 1945, who is Irish, and I think it speaks for itself.
Thank you.
So while they're setting up for the next one, which is Cowboy Christmas, the name kind of speaks for itself. You'll hear some familiar melodies and some familiar rhythms and some familiar Christmas carols all mashed up together in something that, I don't know, I really like it. I think the band really likes it as well. I hope you do.
Thank you.
So while people are setting up for our next piece, you might have noticed that we have five ladies and gentlemen in the back who are covering an enormous variety and number of instruments back there. My joke throughout our rehearsal period has been that no percussionist should be left behind during Christmas. So they write, you know, we've got whistles and temple blocks and horseshoes, chimes, triangle, wiro, vibra slap. So it's all those people in the back in high school band who really can't do very much musically get to shine during Christmas. I'm just saying. The next piece we're going to do is Blue Christmas, which was popularized by Elvis Presley in 1957. I wikied it recently, and I think there are over 1,000 different recordings of this.
Thank you.
Yes, another medley.
But this is a double medley, not only a medley of some Christmas tunes, but also a medley of different musical styles. Everything from sort of choral to swing and even funk. You remember funk, right? It was like 70s? Okay, so here we go. This is a show-stopping Christmas. Our next piece is an Irving Berlin Christmas, and these are three well-known pieces that are drawn from the 1942 movie Holiday Inn. They were all sung by Bing Crosby and, oh, over the years, pretty much everybody again. The first one is Happy Holidays. The second one is White Christmas, which didn't really get very popular until 1954 when a new version came out. And then finally, Let's Start the New Year Right. Thank you. Christmas concert. You should have some more words there. I hope you know the music. We're going to supply the music anyway. Hopefully you will accompany us with your voices. And Chris, do you want to do some honors as well? You got to help her out though. Thank you.
Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, don your headgear. You do.
Where'd it go?
Oh.
Nice dress. Nice balls,
Ruby. Sleigh bells at the ready!
Oh, yeah. Don't play.
Two bars.
Thank you.